This week on the bonus stage,
girl next door Eva checks out the world's toughest phone, the Sonim XP3.
Nice. Because we're always topsy-turvy and, you know,
of course.
This is the way we roll, man.
We're in the eye of the storm.
Eye of the tiger.
Okay, check this out. A delicate flower like Eva, our good Eva.
She's very delicate.
Yeah. Plus, the toughest phone in the world equals a Razer Tech review.
That's right.
So check
it away.
Hey guys, I'm going to do a tech review today over this phone called the Sonim XP3. It's not available in Singapore yet, but it's such a cool phone. I had to do the first review here in Singapore, and I'll tell you why it's so awesome. Oops. What? You want to break up with me? You pig! You know you make me break up.
Hi, Eva. Oh yeah, the phone is absolutely still alive. I mean, I'm still calling you on the phone, although it's disgusting because it's been in like pond water for like over 30 minutes.
So the phone has been underwater for 30 minutes. It's also been left in the rain for 20 minutes. And let's check it. Is it still alive? It's still alive. You know, Ed, a lot of phones these days have to be treated like eggs, you know? Very fragile. If you drop it, it breaks into a billion pieces, or it just doesn't work on the inside. We're going to see if this Humpty Dumpty breaks into a billion pieces, or whether it survives down the stairs. So I'm going to throw it down the stairs. Okay.
Still working?
Ed, it's still working. I know that some people who have very fragile gadgets, like the iPod Nano, they put it into their back pocket, they sit down and it cracks. But for this one, okay, it's pretty big. Not sure if it's going to fit in my back pocket. Okay, it can just fit in my back pocket. I'm going to try sitting. Yeah, I want to try sitting on it and see if it cracks. Okay, no. It's a bit uncomfortable, but it doesn't crack at all. Okay, now you guys have seen how much this phone has gone through today, but it's not over yet. I'm going to put this phone through one final test. So I'm going to get my colleague to call me and have it ringing and still see if it works while the Razer Mobile drives over it. So call away. Okay, so our Razer Mobile has driven over the Sonim XP3, but it seems that the phone has turned off, even though the screen and the hardware is intact. What's wrong with this, Ed? Is it not working anymore?
Well, it's not just not working, because like the point of it was that when the van drove over the Sonim XP3, it went over the call off button, so it just turned off the phone by mistake.
Right.
All you can do, right, to prove the phone is still operational, we're gonna turn it on. Okay, and it is turning on. This phone has survived the van. And yes, it's still working.
Can we do it one more time then?
Yes, you can do it one more time.
Okay.
This time we're going to lock the keypad to make sure it doesn't turn off when the wheel goes over it.
Okay, great.
All yours.
Okay. So take two. Okay, so for our test number two, we actually had the screen facing down as the van rolled over. But surprisingly, the second time had more damage or inflicted more damage onto the phone. As you can see, if you close up, the gravel imprints. So you have to roll over the screen up. But don't take my word for it. Okay, so thanks, Ed, for joining me today and helping me put the Sonim XP3 to the test.
Okay.
Are there any other features that you'd like to highlight about this phone? I know that there's a built-in torch, so it's very friendly for the outdoorsy type. It can withstand fog, rain, salt, air. How about the temperature? Can you elaborate on what temperatures it can last in?
Okay, so the Sonim XP3 is also able to follow you wherever you want to go. You could be up in the Everest, you could be down in the Sahara. This thing can take thermal shock from minus 20 degrees to like 60 degrees Celsius. So this is really tough.
It's for the outdoorsy types. Okay, well, thanks, Ed. Now, you look like you've been through a lot more than the phone has.
Absolutely, man. I'm absolutely all wet. I think I wish I was like the phone just as tough as this.
Bye, guys.
So, one, do you think the Sonim XP3 is a tough phone? Okay. Thank you, one.
Okay, great.
Expert review!
Expert review,
everyone! Right. He said a lot in that little nod, yes, of it, like, you know.
Subtle nuances.
Yeah, you know, sending all these signals. You guys are not in the living room with us, so you don't know what he's saying, but we get it.
Basically, someone that big stood on the phone and he knows how tough and heavy he can be. Anyway!
That's right, no, but okay, seriously, the phone does bring, like, I mean, it looks like a really old school phone.
Yeah.
And like what Mothership actually said was, like, you know, it looks a bit like a brick.
Yeah.
And so aesthetically, it's not the prettiest of phones.
Yeah.
But it is tough.
It's function over form.
Yeah, right? Function over form.
Function over form. It reminds me of the old Nokia phone. I can't remember the exact model number, but it was it came in orange, blue, and it has two pieces, you sort of like break them apart. And I used to use
when I was in the NS.
It was a really good phone, and I sold it off to one of the regulars. So I guess this phone is for people who work, I don't know, hard labor, you know, construction
actually,
worker.
Actually, this phone
Navy
could be
guys.
It could be a phone for like army, because you know it doesn't have like a camera, right?
Standard issue, SAF.
Standard issue, man. I wouldn't mind like
the government pay for the phone.
I was just thinking whether I would mind going through army if I had a free phone, but I don't think so.
I think
I'll still mind going through army.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Anyway, it's Apple!